one. There we go. Alright, last time on Danganronpa. We thought Kyoko had died when we really didn't think so, but the characters thought so, so that was the thing. We found another character called Mukura. We're pretty sure she died. We thought Monokumo had died, but hadn't died. So we're in a class trial! With no clear idea who really killed who, but I got a working theory that Kyoko is the one that killed Mukuro, but that means that she would die this trial. Which is a little sketchy. If anything, I could see her dying next trial, maybe? But yeah, anywho, let's do it. All right, set skills, which I don't really have any because none of the characters haven't actually given me any. All right, let's do it. Trial time, baby.
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results. If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate. Okay, well, I'll leave the rest up to you.
Well then, let's discuss the specifics of the victim. First, we need to clarify who exactly the unidentified victim is.
And that'd be Mukuro.
It's Kyoko. There's no other explanation.
Okay, Hiro, Kyoko's standing right next to me. How?
But Kyoko's standing right there.
Clearly that's a ghost.
That's a ghost!
Yep, see, there it is.
But she has legs and stuff.
Well, that's just because she's like the latest evolution in ghost technology.
Okay, wow, both of them combined, just... Tina, I love you so much, but... Oh my god.
There's a limit to how much ridiculousness I can tolerate.
Okay. So I just have to prove that the corpse isn't Kyoko, right? Then let's compare Kyoko's traits to the traits of the dead body.
Her traits?
One important trait Kyoko has that proves the body doesn't belong to her. Love?
I got it! I'm talking about her gloves. They'll give us some insight into the mystery. I'm sure of it.
In that case, I think it would be helpful if someone explained why she actually wears those gloves.
And would you happen to know the answer?
Scars.
In fact, Monokuma told me. Apparently, you have scars on your hands you don't want anyone to see.
Super, hey buddy, morning.
Oh, you know, now that I think about it...
Good, yeah.
The corpse wasn't wearing any gloves, right?
Currently going into trial 5. I'm hoping maybe if we could try to beat this today, because apparently we only have one more chapter after this, and that's it.
They probably just got burnt up in the explosion. I'm not convinced. The ghost is just trying to fool us all.
Okay, Hiro. There's no way that the corpse was Kyoko. Because Kyoko's standing right here. Why are we debating this? Oh. Hiro, you make my brain hurt. It's not because like a coffee thing. But if I can't prove why, we're gonna be stuck here and the case won't move forward because I'm dealing with idiots. We're debating whether or not Kyoko to my right is Kyoko. So I don't have any choice but to. Because somehow Hiro and Hina think that maybe Kyoko is not Kyoko. Fake nails. That looks pretty right. How could she have long nails if she wears gloves
that
all the time?
Kyoko there is just a ghost.
Impossible.
Okay, then prove it. Prove she's not a ghost.
The dead body wasn't wearing gloves.
Okay.
They got burnt up in the explosion.
Then she was wearing gloves before the explosion?
And
well, yeah, she must have been wearing gloves. Because that wrong. Corpse is absolutely
Kyoko.
Missed.
Because she's a zombie.
This discussion is idiotic.
Yeah, no, this ties totally perfectly in our dystopian, like, thought process of it being on the outside. It's we're all zombies, chat. We are all zombies. They become one with the atom. Willow, morning. I'm late, what did I miss? So I'm trying to persuade Hiro and Hina that the Kyoko standing to my right is not a walking corpse or a ghost. Mainly Hiro, but Hina's not helping the whole thing.
Yeah.
That's all you missed. Yeah.
That Kyoko there is just a ghost.
Impossible.
Okay, then prove it.
The dead body wasn't wearing gloves.
They got burnt up in the explosion.
Then she was wearing gloves before the explosion.
Well, yeah, she must have been wearing gloves.
Wrong. Nails, no, dude. Wrong. She's got, like, fingernails that are, like, yay long. Well, like, yay long. Fashionista
no,
nails.
There's no way the corpse was wearing gloves.
Because you can't wear fake nails with gloves. I mean, you can, and I've had an ex-girlfriend who's done that, and it was idiotic because she broke the nails. Says she whole thing. Never mind.
Whoever it was, they were wearing fake nails. Remember? I imagine trying to wear gloves over nails like that would have been a pretty big pain.
Which. Can we all agree that one thing a little strange here, also, grats Willow, is if you, also grats Super, if you are the ultimate soldier, right, wearing fake nails really, really doesn't help you. It hinders your ability to fight, it hinders your ability to shoot a weapon. It's pretty big hindrance. I'm more than positive Kyoko is Makuro. And they flipped it. I mean, yeah, they might have flipped it the other way where, like, she put the fake nails on her. But I don't know. I'm thinking it's the other way around.
Besides, Kyoko wears gloves to hide her hands, right? It'd be pretty weird for someone who's self-conscious about their hands to wear fake nails, don't you think?
I love how that's the area we're going into, but, I mean, hey, you know what? It's not wrong.
Jeez, man, you don't know women, huh? They're complicated like that.
SJ, morning. Let me guess.
Women, it's you.
Oh, take a guess, because whatever it is, I don't think you're going to guess as much as what you think, because I would never guess this. Makoto's the only one left out and attempting to convict himself. No, it's worse than that, actually. So Hiro doesn't believe Kyoko to my right is Kyoko. He thinks she's a ghost, and we're trying to persuade him that she's not a ghost and or a zombie. Oja!
Well, Kyoko, any thoughts?
These gloves were custom made to the size of my hands to make sure they don't interfere with my daily life.
You know, that sounds like something an ultimate soldier who wants to have a custom fit to beat the shit out of somebody.
If I wore fake nails, the gloves wouldn't fit properly.
Oh, this game's really turned shark. Yeah, no, it's jumping the shark. Yeah. Side note. Kind of can't wait till we get to Danganronpa 2. Because if this is where the insanity is going now, you only go down from here.
Then that's that. The dead body doesn't belong to Kyoko.
Which should have been obvious since she's standing right here.
Okay, so then, who's the real victim? First, we need to figure that out.
Oh, now he's okay.
That's
okay.
The first thing I said. You're the one who's been dragging us around in circles.
Are we sure Hiro really isn't supposed to be here to bog everything down?
with his dumb or fake dumb. Because remember, he said, I've been solidifying. When we asked him why he started acting like this, he said something to the effect of, I only recently solidified my personality or character. And it's like, wait, what? Before anything, we have to identify the victim. Everything starts from there. Okay. So the only likely victim would be Makuro. Tattoo on the right hand.
If Kyoko really is still alive, then who died?
There's gotta be some way to figure it out. I don't think so. The face was scorched beyond recognition.
That's true.
And there wasn't any description in the Monokuma file.
Also true.
Well, if we can't identify the body...
then there's nothing else we can do, right?
Well, no, we can't identify the body.
So...
then who died?
There's gotta be... I don't think so. And there wasn't any description...
Well, if we can't identify the body...
There we go.
No, that's wrong.
I can't watch Danganronpa Robot 3 without watching 2. And 2 only exists in game 4. Yeah, it's weird, right?
There was one clue left behind that we can use to identify the body.
I mean, I guess to a certain point, it does mean that you'd have to watch everything they do if everything connects. That's why there's no victim. Serious. They can't tell who's dead. Apparently, well, to be fair, the victim currently dead... the victim that died had their face eliminated. The file on them is pretty vague. And they're a person that we haven't really met. Now, we're aware of a 16th person, but at this point in the game, it's really a 50-50 whether it is the victim is Makuro or somebody else that Monokuma has just been absently, you know, decided not to say anything. Be like, it's fine. The process of elimination doesn't work when the game wants to constantly keep throwing curveballs at you, and some of those curveballs literally come out of nowhere. Like, literally.
What? For real? If you're lying, you'll die a cruel and unusual death.
A cruel and unusual death? This I gotta see.
It's I'm gonna be really, really, really honest with you, chat. Beginning of the game, really good detective. Halfway through to the end of the game so far. Anime bullshit. Thank you. I really like this game. But as far as detective games go, the first half really good. But after a certain point, it's almost as if the creators... this is going to sound so cruel to me. Weren't smart enough to come up with clever ways? Like, to be really fair, it to make a detective game, really got to be into it. You know what I mean? Like, I would almost say you have to be pretty smart, pretty clever to come up with mechanics and a design scheme to kill somebody that works, right? So, first half, really good. Second half, not so good, but the story's good in terms of, like, what the hell's going on? Yeah, they ran out of people and need more people. I mean, yeah, it's going to loot your options, but... Anywho, give me 1 second. I'm going to go blow my nose. I've been dealing with allergies all day. No, actually, so that is a little bit of a misnomer. At the first class trial, it was Togami and Kyoko that noticed that there was a 16th chair. Monokumo refused to explain why there were 16 chairs. And so everyone assumed that there was another player involved, but then at certain points in the story, they forgot about it? And then now it's coming back up? So it's... like, if it was constantly in the background of your brain as you're floating along, being like, well, one of these people could be the killer, or it could be the 16th unknown person, that'd be one thing. But in most of the class trials, except for the first and this one, the 16th character was the only time that they've ever popped it up, right? So it's... to be really fair, I feel like writing a story... a detective story, so much harder to do because you have to make it easy enough for the person, the reader, or the player to kind of pick up on the breadcrumbs while also making it challenging enough and entertaining enough, but also logical, right? There's a series of events that if you were to map it all out, it would make sense and that would be like, that would be the murder. But then repeat that multiple times as the pool of victims shrink and try to elevate the situation and the tension. And it's like, that's really hard to do. It's why you probably don't see a whole lot of games doing it because, or if they do it, they do it once. That's the entire game. 35 hours in. Yeah. Yeah. From what I'm hearing though, Danganronpa 1, 2, 2 is extra long and extra bloated, which is what I'm hearing, like, from out the gate. It's like bonkers crazy. Doesn't always make a whole lot of sense. But apparently, the third game is short, confined, but really entertaining murderers and victims in clever ways that the killers go about doing their job. That makes sense. And it's like, ooh. So... I'm looking forward to the train wreck that might be 2, but, like, the exquisiteness that might be 3. Want to make your MC look stupid either by making it too easy to figure out. Exactly. But they kind of make Makoto a little too simple. I mean, we've had people coming in with, like, their name, like Makoto's name, and then simp. I didn't know that was a thing, so, yeah. Really good, even with the first 10 minutes. See, that's... yeah. Same as the start. Well, I would say that Makoto has gotten a lot better. He's actually grown as a character. It's just, like, simple things that are even simple to me. Look, I'm below the bar, chat. I know this. I understand this. I get it. I know where I fall in place, all right? If I get it and you don't, oh, we in trouble. Like, there's some things that I completely skipped on, but, like, other things like, wait, how did dude connect to this and go over here and have a whole thing? Okay, sorry. Still really salty about the dude thing. I'm sorry. I am. I really am. The more I'm enjoying Final Fantasy VII Remake, the more I'm excited for the possibilities. Could actually get it. Well, actually, we know they're gonna make a sequel, and the only reason why? Oh, 3.5 million copies already. That's fast. That's real
She's
fast.
Just being stupid. Ignore them, Makoto. Tell us what you're talking about.
The key to figuring out who it was is the tattoo on the back of her hand.
Well, to be fair, for the old game of Final Fantasy VII, characters died in that as well, but from what I'm hearing here is the consequence and the impact is greater because you get to know characters, but they also go...
Oh, yeah. The design's pretty strange, huh? Is this a dog?
Her master must have made her get it to be like, you're my bitch.
Oh god.
Seriously? It really did something that humiliating?
No, that's not it. The identity of the victim is hidden within that tattoo.
Oh, really?
If you compare the tattoo to the other information we have, the victim's identity should become clear. I really want to know how Chicken Coop's gonna fall into this. I am more than curious about that.
I got it.
But where does the chicken come in?
That's the name of the military group Mukuro Ikusaba belonged to.
It's a chicken.
Okay, so
to show that they're a member of the team, each soldier that joins the squad would get a tattoo representing Fenrir somewhere on their body.
It's a situation where our choices throughout the second game could impact the entire game and even ending. I'll be very honest, I don't see Square Enix going to the full extreme of Mass Effect. I could see them having certain things, but not the entire game. I might be wrong, but like, it can be very, like, I could see surface level changes of like whether a character is alive or not, but it doesn't really impact everything. It's a more of it's a personal impact, right? It's not a like game changer impact. It's just like it's just to you, which to be fair, that actually might be a lot better because again, it's personal. It impacts you, your playthrough, and straight to who you are.
Fenrir?
The image that represents Fenrir is... why am I... Hangman's Gambit? It's a wolf.
Now I understand.
Okay.
The representation of Fenrir is a wolf.
Fenrir, the wolf of Ragnarok. It's from Norse mythology. A huge, world-ending wolf beast. He's the child of the trickster god Loki, and a female giant.
I don't want to do my own horn, but four-letter words I can pretty much spell. I go to five letters, things get a little wishy-washy. A little bit.
Man, after all this time, we finally got a glimpse of the literary all-star.
Wait, I think the feather might mean it was Toko who killed the 16. She sneezed back and forth. So what, are you thinking that, like, a chicken grabbed her and she sneezed? Or are you thinking she used the chicken and then, like, grabbed the chicken butt and, like, rubbed it in her face, sneezed, flipped back over, and ran back?
Exactly. The body we found had a tattoo of a wolf, which means that person must have once belonged to Fenrir.
Actually, real quick, SJ, do we know if you can hook up with Barrett in Final Fantasy VII Remake? Did they pull that, or... Because I know you can hang out with Tifa, which that's my waifu right there. You can! Hey! Get on Square Enix! Yeah, cool. I mean, we're gonna go up to Tifa because it's Tifa, but... Yeah. Good on them for keeping most of that. So, yeah.
So it must have been Mukuro.
Mukuro.
What?
Hold on. Isn't she the one that was behind this whole thing?
Yes, but really, Willow, I want her, like, taking a chicken and just rubbing it on her face. I want that as an image. I really do.
You sound surprised, but you're absolutely right. Yes, indeed. The trial this time is to solve the murder of Mukuro Ikusaba.
What? Are you saying the mastermind is dead? And now we have to have a cool-ass trial?
No. It means we were wrong in thinking that Mukuro was the mastermind at all.
But I mean, being the ultimate despair seems like a pretty mastermindy title to me.
Maybe we shouldn't have been thinking of her as the ultimate despair in the first place.
The ultimate soldier who happens to wear really long fingernails, which wouldn't really, I mean, I know it's anime, but like, as somebody who's been in a situation that had to use fake nails, because clearly when you do a charity thing and you make a promise, you gotta keep it. But yeah, it's really hard to do anything without being like breaking them. You become unusually self-aware.
After
God,
all,
I can think balling up a fist.
I didn't see anything that would fit such a description.
Who hasn't watched much of the anime and has never played this game and has much? Is batshit insane? Yes, it is. Yeah, a hard mode in Final Fantasy VII Remake is hard. Again, I watched Gerard. I didn't watch him. I saw tweets on about what he was doing. 9 hours to beat the final boss on hard mode. Final Fantasy VII Remake. I was watching Strippin play early game hard mode, and it looked like pulling like toenails would be better.
All it said was that she was the ultimate soldier. If I remember correctly, that other information came from...
Okay, the only thing I can assume then is if she really is who she says she is, then on her days off, she has really long fingernails. But then at the same time, why would you have really long fingernails in a game of murder? Also, more importantly, if Mukuro was the one that was dressed up that went to assault us the night before, where was her fingernails? They weren't on there. She had her hand extended like this, and she was like this. There was nothing on her hand.
Kyoko, that's what you told Makoto, right?
So that means Kyoko got it wrong?
Who was she? Who was Mukuro Ikusaba? She's been gone this whole time, and when she finally turns up, she gets killed.
Usually, when there's a scene where an important character dies, it has a lot more detail.
So you're saying she wasn't an important character?
Oh my god, I got like the dumbest idea. Like, super dumb. Mukuro is actually an identical twin to Kyoko. One sister killed the other. And then switched. Either switched or like killed one, and they were maybe like going back and forth. Kind of like the Parent Trap, except for a lot deadlier and more violent. Spend an entire day on a single boss. You basically have to conserve all your MP for the end of the chapter.
Which would mean she
was the same
as us.
I mean, at least it's hard. It's hard.
Just another participant.
Then who's the real mastermind?
It must have been the Hope's Peak Academy headmaster, after all.
No, the headmaster has nothing to do with it.